Item number, SCP-238. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. SCP-238 is currently contained by the original means. Current SCP protocols have proven unable to fully contain SCP-238. All exploration of SCP-238 is suspended until full sustained containment has been achieved. Any and all personnel attempting to enter SCP-238 are to be physically restrained and moved to an outside containment area. Upkeep of the current barrier is top priority, and a minimum of 2 personnel are to be present at all times for upkeep and security. No testing, samples, or exploration may be conducted within SCP-238 until full containment of SCP-238 has been achieved, or with approval by Site Overwatch. Any and all persons entering are to be deemed missing, presumed dead. Description: SCP-238 is an enormous underground facility, with a single entrance on the island Shmidta to the extreme north of Russia. Tunnel networks have been shown to extend for thousands of kilometers, with major junctions under data expunged. When originally found, the entrance was sealed behind a massive wall of bricks, covered in carvings. This wall was removed, and exploration began. Initial tests showed that the walls of SCP-238 were primarily fossilized tissue of unknown origin. Several structures within the facility led initial exploration teams to conclude that SCP-238 is, or was, at least half biological. Shortly after discovery of a central chamber, reported to consist of partially rotted flesh and badly decayed metal structures, personnel began to disappear, and numerous accidents claimed 8 lives. Noises and other hallucinations were reported. 8 containment walls and associated personnel were destroyed by unknown means, with a survivor reporting unconfirmed, in addition to rapidly escalating aggressive phenomenon by SCP-238. Replacement of the original wall has contained the item effectively, but new SCP containment and research strategies have been requested, as the current containment prevents in-depth exploration and experimentation. Addendum 238-S7. Upon the escape of 6 juvenile instances of SCP-1013, the local SCP team assigned to SCP-238 reported SCP-1013 squeezing through the original wall and entering the underground chambers. After several members of the O5 Council and Dr. were notified, they elected to send in a single team to retrieve SCP-1013. Further information regarding the expedition is found in Document 238-S7A, with clearance level 3 required. The end result of the retrieval team were 6 dead, 2 critically injured, 1 missing in action, and the 6 juvenile SCP-1013 instances being recaptured. Further research into SCP-238 will be carried out under SCP supervision. Document 238-S7A, audio log of retrieval of SCP-1013. Begin. Skip 3 hours 41 minutes 16 seconds. Personnel D-299. I don't see nothing. Not that damn thing we're looking for, not that f***ing suit that was supposed to watch us, not even a exit. Agent, you will hold your comments. Agent is currently covering the central chamber, so nothing can escape. Personnel D-299. Like us? I don't see... Agent, shut it. Personnel D-299. Why I have to... Agent, I said quiet. Now! Personnel D-299. Carry on like a f***ing Boy Scout. Agent, shut the hell up, you idiot. There's movement up ahead. Sounds of scraping and grinding are heard. Several minutes pass. Personnel D-299. That don't look like number, but that ain't natural. Agent, incomprehensible. It's not. Delta 2-9-er-9-er, open fire, now! Sounds of gunfire are heard. Agent, life signs terminated. Personnel D-299, life signs terminated. End. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-237, Self-Made Man, right now. or for the complete course, watch this playlist.